One is, of course, we are very rural based. So I don't think the easier way to answer would be we have hardly any exposure to the metros or the urban center. All our branches are very rural based, or our customers are in villages. So almost all our exposure is rural India. And kind of if you ask me where the growth is going to come from, we've tracked our customers. They are in 330,000 villages of this country. We believe that in the next 12 months to 18 months, we're planning to add customers in next 100,000 village where we are in present. And we are a very multi-product company, right from UVs to cars to trucks, construction equipment, pre-owned vehicle, tractors, all kinds of product around there. We are also into SME segment. Our book is about 7-8% of the book is in SME. So I would think a growth would not come from any one geography or one product, but it's going to be very clearly a multi-product, multi-geography approach, but very rural focused.
That's correct, sir. With a good sowing season and an outlook of a good monsoons this year consecutively, this is the third year that we are seeing. How is the tractor, farm equipment, and rural financing looking like, especially on the back of a strong tractor sales in this year?
So clearly, rural is driven by sentiments, which means if the monsoon is expected to be average plus, and if that's the news in the knowing already, and therefore you will see the sentiments drive positive, and the reflection of that is seen in volumes of product that we can see. I think it's also important rural has two streams of cash flow: farm cash flow and the infra cash flow. What we've seen the year gone by and possibly this year also is different states have different infra projects, maybe road, maybe bridges, maybe local activity, municipal activities. So there is a infra cash flow which is visible. Coupled with farm cash flow, I think the overall consumption would be good, the overall buying pattern would be good, and we do see footfalls at the dealerships high, and our own volumes have registered high numbers.
Right. So with the increasing crude oil prices, do you think that sort of will have an impact on the tractor sales, and it will also impact the disbursement growth going ahead?
I think it's important to understand these are vehicles, whether it's tractors, vehicles, commercial vehicle, any of this product, they are all earn and pay products, right? So therefore, what really impacts a buying, that's been my understanding, is the asset value. If it goes up and goes up substantially, then people do think, do I need to buy now? Can I wait for some more time? Can I use my existing vehicle for a longer time? But otherwise, if you look at the fuel price, you look at the interest cost, they are operating costs. Yes, to start with, it may impact their earnings, but very quickly, they also pass on this to the ultimate consumer. So I'm not convinced that operating cost increases must have or will have any kind of an impact on the buying pattern. But clearly, if the overall buying price goes up, then of course people do relook at whether they should delay their buy.
Correct. So as far as we talk about AUMs are concerned, what is the sort of the I mean, I'm sorry, as far as the AUM mix is concerned, do you think the lending in SME space or the used vehicle space or as far as CVs are concerned, what is the sort of trend looking like there?
So clearly, we currently have about 45% of the book or 47% of the book come from the Mahindra vehicles, tractors kind of a segment. The other 53-55% comes from the non-Mahindra, which is 30-odd% comes from car, 7-8% comes from construction equipment and commercial vehicle, and another 7-8% comes from pre-owned vehicle or used vehicle, and then the balance being SME. If you look at the base, definitely SME is at a low base, used vehicles, that is pre-owned vehicle, is at a low base, and commercial vehicle at a low base. So the growth rate of these businesses will be higher. But if you look at the overall growth, if you think UV or tractor for us grows even at 10-12%, it's on a very large base. So on an absolute volume basis, one would see UV, tractors, cars contributing high value. But on a growth rate basis, you would see it comes from pre-owned vehicle, commercial vehicle, SME segment.
Correct. So what is the current branch network looking like, and are there any expansion plans or consolidation plans going in FY19?
So we added about 100-odd branch in the fourth quarter of last year. They would all start producing results during this period. When we have 100,000 village that what I talked of wanted to be added during this year,
correct,
would call for another 100-odd branch that we would add during the year. Now, there is no state where we aren't present, but I think within the state, there would be enough districts that we can cover. And therefore, we will look at 100 more branches during the year that we would add.
Correct. So what's your outlook as far as OEMs are concerned? And again, then would it have an impact on the disbursements of growth?
So clearly, we work with all the OEMs and we find new products reaching those markets. We started working with Renault, we're working with Nissan. We were a very significant player as far as Maruti is concerned. Our market share and volumes are growing with Hyundai, with Tata Motors. And of course, we are very, very strongly supported by the Mahindra range of vehicles and tractors. So I think there's, without exception to any OEM, we work with all of them. We believe that we have an ability to take them to deeper pockets and get them a new segment of customer from those markets. I think it's also important to understand we worked with closely, what, about 6 million customers so far. And they are all into those villages that I talked of. And we use them as our extended sales organization. They get us more inquiry from that market. And we self-generate something like 15-20% of the volumes every month.
Correct. So if we talk about your subsidiaries, the rural housing finance, what has the sort of loan growth been there? And if we talk about RBI being indicative that, you know, small ticket loans have been a concern for housing finance. So for Mahindra Finance, is that also a concern?
I must clarify, small ticket loan, if they are collateral backed, they will never be a concern, for simple reason that someone who borrows from those assets understand for what are they taking, and then they would either acquire an asset with that money or they will use the money for upgradation of that asset. So in our case, if you take the rural housing, we do a house improvement loan, like a room addition, room expansion loan. They are small ticket loans, 1 lakh, 1.5 lakh, 2 lakh loan. But what they are willing to offer as a collateral is the land which on which the house is built. Now, somebody is not going to give you a 15-20 lakh rupee asset for a 2 lakh of rupee loan. They are willing to do that because they very clearly understand what are they taking this loan for. And our own experiences in the last 10 years that we've run this business is we've had a growth rate of upward of 40-50%. The potential is very large. The product is very, very well defined to suit the requirement of the consumer. But it does have its own pain point that when the season is not good, there is a failure of crop, that the installments do get delayed. But the delay is not necessarily a default or a bad debt. Right, the delay, the money does come back. So I don't think we have a quality issue out there while there are some delays in installments. I don't think this is an unsecured loan that one needs to worry about. Is this money lost in case of any default? It has an underlying collateral. I think it's a very healthy business which is registered 40% growth and we run a balance sheet of close to about 7,000 crore.
Correct. So as far as the recovery rate is concerned, is there some sort of trend that you foresee here?
So clearly we see that our gross NPAs had gone up to beyond 10%. It's come down a little. But not across the country. Like now Maharashtra is a little high and I very strongly think in this round when they get the crop money, even that amount would come back. At some stage, Tamil Nadu had registered a very high NPA. Once the market conditions improved, the season changed, the NPAs have come down to 3%. I think a business like this will at any point of time could have a high gross NPA, but in the next season the NPA do get corrected. But eventually in a financial services one needs to measure the credit loss. And I don't think this businesses will have credit loss upward of 0.5% to 1%.
Sure. So